And welcome back to Patreon Pop. Would you believe it's been 1 year since my first show? Since my anniversary, I put together something special for you. I'll tell you more about that later in the show, but for now, go check out the charts. January is a quiet month, and with the world locked down, the charts are quiet too. However, at 30, there was a drop for Bebe Rexha and Doja Cat. Baby I'm Jealous is down too. Internet Money climbed back up 1 to 29 with Lemonade. And What You Know About Love is up 1 to 28 for Pop Smoke. Lil Nas is down 1 to 27 with Holiday. And Miley Cyrus and Dua Lipa are down 2 to 26 with Prisoner. Save Your Tears is a non-mover at 25 for The Weeknd. But Taylor Swift climbs 3 to 24 with Willow. Ed Sheeran's Afterglow is a non-mover at 23. Put Your Records On is still at 22 for Rit Momney. And Machine Gun Kelly and Black Bear stay at 21 with My Ex's Best Friend. Well, remember that something special that I told you about earlier on? Well, this is it. Since it's my anniversary, my mom thought it would be a great idea to interview me so you guys can know more about me. Just so you know, I'm really, really sorry about this. Enjoy.
Okay. Tell me a bit about you.
My name is Peyton Reese Wade. I'm an 11-year-old singer-songwriter from Dublin, Ireland. And I am also an actress.
And where do you go to school?
I go to school at St. Gabriel's Catholic School, but next year I will be going to Cardinal Carter.
So when did you realize that you wanted to be a singer and an actress?
When I was small, I watched my first movie, and I was like, wow, Peyton in movies. And for the singing part of it, I just was always humming and always singing along. I could sing before I could talk. I live my life in pantomime.
That's right. So what classes have you since taken when you decided that this was going to be your future?
I have taken acting classes, singing classes, and I took ballet classes for a while. And I take piano and guitar classes.
And you've been doing your show now for a year, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what inspired you to start it?
Well, my dad and I kind of came up with the idea of it because I wasn't really confident on speaking and I needed kind of a bit of help with it. So my dad thought it would be a great idea to start a show where I'm counting down and I have to speak to be able to do that. So, yeah.
You enjoy it though?
Yes, of course, yeah.
What have you learned from doing the show?
What I have learned is that you have to be really confident about what you're going to say before you can actually say it on camera, because it can take a long time if you don't know what you're saying and you don't really understand it.
So, is it hard being so ambitious while still being a tween?
Well, it can be sometimes, because sometimes you just want to be yourself and you want to go out, play with your friends, have sleepovers with your friends, yeah. Maybe take a small break to go swimming or something like that. But you also need to be able to focus on what you want to do in your life, because it's going to be very important for the next part in your life.
So tell us a little bit about your typical day. What does it look like?
After the alarm goes off again, I go to feed my fish, named Indigo, and I then go to eat my breakfast, and then I go to school.
So you come home, you're on the school bus, you come home, what
happens? I go on the school bus, yeah. I come home, and then I would normally do my homework,
mm-hmm.
Eat dinner, and then I would play either my piano or my guitar. And sometimes, if I want to mess around, I pull up the electric drum and I plug my earphones in it so my parents don't get mad at me.
question. So obviously on your off time, what are your friends?
My best friends have actually, well, two of them have been on here. The other one sadly can't really be over right now. But you've met Ella and you've met Isla, the two crazies. And they just love to hang out with me. I love to hang out with them. We have sleepovers all the time. We have back-to-back birthday parties, and it's great.
And, okay, which leads me to my next question. What draws you to them?
Oh, they're definitely their craziest. They're, for Isla, she ran up to me on the first day of school in SK, and she just ran up to me and gave me a big hug. She was like, "We're gonna be best friends," and I've known her ever since. And Ella was the really quiet one that you couldn't get to talk. But then nowadays, she just doesn't want to shut up. She's great, though.
And then you mentioned there was a third one. Who's
the third one? The third one is Erin. Erin is the smarty pants of the group. She loves to read books, and she's super fun. She loves to bake. She loves all different activities.
Wow, sounds like a well-rounded group, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you call yourselves?
We call ourselves the Awesome Foursome.
If you could live in any place in the world or off-world.
Oh, God.
Or off-world.
Okay.
Where would it be and why?
Okay. So, if I were to stay on Earth,
okay,
it would definitely be with my AC, which stands for anti-crazy, not like aircon. in London. London, England.
Okay.
Well, London, Ontario. London, England. Because she and I just get along perfectly. And we love to play games together, and we don't really get to see each other, but when we do, we're all over each other, and we love each other so much. So I'd probably live with her, but if I were to go off-world, I would definitely live on that weird planet in Lost in Space, because I could find the program Lost in Space,
yeah,
because I could find that big weird robot.
So who is your favorite artist or band?
Oh, okay. Right now, currently, my favorite artist, my favorite band, well, I have two favorite bands, but currently, like, in this time,
yeah,
my favorite band is Maroon 5.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But then if I were to go back,
yeah,
lots of years, yep, that's the word. Thank you, lots of years. Probably going back to the Beatles.
Oh, great choice.
Yeah. And then my favorite artist would probably either be Elton John or...
someone more current?
Gabby Barrett.
Oh, wow. Okay, great choices. So, who is your favorite current actor?
Actor?
Mm.
Oh. Definitely Margot Robbie.
Really?
Yes, I love her as...
Why?
She is literally my favorite because she is just the best ever Harley Quinn. She makes everyone laugh, and I love Harley Quinn, so
fair enough.
It just works.
What's your favorite song?
Ooh, Girls Like You by Maroon 5.
Oh, brilliant song. And what is your favorite movie?
Oh, my favorite, oh gosh, this is a terrible question. There are so many movies out there. Probably...
The first one that springs to mind, then.
Spider-Man Homecoming.
Interesting. So, what is the last movie you watched that you hadn't seen before?
Oh, Soul.
Soul?
Yeah, remember the one with the music guy, the jazz guy?
Oh, yeah.
The animated one?
The boring guy?
No, he's not that boring. I mean, it is a story about a dead guy, kind of, but it's fun. It's okay.
Oh,
it's the last movie I haven't seen before.
Okay, fine. Fair enough. Well, you answered the question. So, here's another one that should be interesting, and take your time to answer this one. What and who inspires you?
To me, there are probably four people in my life who inspire me the most. We'll start with the person who has known me for the longest, my Uncle JP.
Okay.
He inspires me because he works so hard at what he does, and he never gives up, and he always loves what he does, even through the hard times of it.
Okay. And he's so just for your viewership.
He's a cricketer.
An ex-South African cricketer. Okay, fair enough.
The second person would be Josh Peach.
Okay, and who's he?
He is my music teacher. He is just the most fabulous person you'll ever meet because his musical references and all sorts of things that he knows about music is just amazing. Because he knows all different genres, all different musical people. Mm. He's just the best person due to music to be a music teacher you'll ever meet.
Oh, fantastic. And he's good with kids, too.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah, did you have a question?
No, I was going to say then, and you mentioned two others.
Then. Yes. The next one is Martina Ortiz Luis.
And who's that?
She sings the national anthem for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And she is one of my best friends. Too many to count, but one of my best friends. I've known her since I was about 6, and she's like my Uncle JP. She works so hard. She gets up at 5 in the morning every day to just work on her music, and she goes to school as well, so she has to do her homework as well as play the instrument she plays. She's also in a movie, in a TV program right now. A couple of TV programs. So she has to work with all of that as well as school.
Wow.
Yes.
And the last person you mentioned?
The last person I want to mention is Mikey. He is just the most fabulous actor you'll ever meet. Ever, ever, ever. He pursues method acting. So what that means is he gets a part and then he really gets into that part. So he becomes that character, and if that character is just a mess, he becomes that mess. And if the character is nice and sweet, he just can't get rid of him. Because he always wants to attach to you in some odd way. So either way, it's just a mess. But it's great.
Very good. Okay, so moving on to the next part of this interesting interview. There's a couple of rules coming up. One word answers only.
Oh, no.
Your answers can be obscure and as funny as you like.
Okay, I have a question.
But only one word answers.
I have a question.
What's that?
Do I get to think about it or do I have a timer on how long it takes?
Let's try and let it flow.
Okay.
Okay, so whatever pops in your mind first, even no matter how silly or obscure it is.
Got it.
Okay, but one word.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, let's go. What is your favorite color?
Scarlet.
Favorite food?
Tacos.
Favorite season?
Winter.
Favorite smell?
Bacon.
Favorite clothes?
Jumpsuits.
Favorite animal?
Arctic wolf.
Favorite drink?
Non-tequila sunrise.
This one word answer is obviously not working. Worst drink?
Root beer.
Favorite emoji?
Swearing emoji.
Favorite Lego?
Baby Yoda.
Favorite book?
Spiderwick 1.
Favorite subject at school?
Art.
Worst subject at school?
Religion.
Which is your favorite parent? You You don't need to answer that. It's fine. I know it's me.
Skip. Just for that, my dad.
Dog. Okay, so you've watched Inside the Actor's Studio. Mm-hmm. So here we're going to go with finishing with some of the questions from Inside the Actor's Studio, from their famous questionnaire.
Got it.
What is your favorite word?
Satisfying.
What is your least favorite word?
Book.
What excites you?
Best friends.
What bores you?
Books.
Oh dear. What sound or noise do you love?
Okay.
What sound or noise do you hate?
I really hate when someone does not tune their guitar. I hate that. I hate the sound of that guitar. It just, it's off. It's not right.
Okay. What is your favorite curse word?
Do I really have to do this?
What is your favorite curse word?
S.
S.
The S word.
Okay. What profession other than your own would you like to attempt?
Cooking.
What profession would you not like to do?
Garbage truck guy.
If heaven exists, what would you like to hear God say when you arrive at that pearly gates?
Finally, someone with a sense of humor.
Thank you. That was very good.
At 20, Shawn Mendes and Justin Bieber's Monster falls too, while Tate McRae is up 1-19 with You Broke Me First. Golden is down 1-18 for Harry Styles, and BTS dropped 3-17 with Dynamite. Jason Derulo climbs 3 places this week. Take You Dancing is up to 16. And Surf Mesa and Emily are another non-mover at 15 with ILY. The Weeknd falls 1-14 with Blinding Lights, but Ariana Grande continues to climb. 34 plus 35 is up to 13. Gabby Barrett stays at 12 with I Hope. And Sam Smith's Diamonds is another non-mover at 11.
My pick of the week this week is from the UK chart. This is Kid Laroi with So Done.
Okay, I realize now that everything that I did was wrong. Okay, I realize now some things are better off said than done. Okay, I realize now that maybe I'm not ready for love. Okay, I realize now I finished us before we begun. I'm done, so done. I'm done with all the games you play. I'm numb, so numb. I'm numb to all the pain you bring. I'm trying to figure this all out for myself. I don't need you or nobody else. I'm done, so done. So done, so done, so done, so done, so done. I'm done.
Well, this is awkward. The top 10 is the same as last week. Yep, it's true. No change at all. So stick with me. I'm gonna go through this fast. At 10, Billie Eilish with Therefore I Am. At 9, it's Laugh Now, Cry Later for Drake and Lil Durk. At 8, Chris Brown and Young Thug are still going crazy. And Lonely stays at 7 for Justin Bieber. AJR remain at 6 with Bang. Dua Lipa and DaBaby are still at 5 with Levitating. Ava Max, Kings and Queens stay at 4. Holy holds on at 3 for Justin Bieber and Chance the Rapper. 24K Golden and Dior remain at 2 with Mood. And Ariana Grande holds on at number 1 for a third week with Positions.
Boy, I'm trying to meet your mama on a Sunday. To make a lot of love on a Monday. Never need no one else, babe. Cause I
5. Bye!